Hey guys, I got Michael here and welcome to the channel. Today here with me for a quick review is the Technocamon 17, less than 3 months from its initial release early May this year. The Camon 17 is one out of the interesting lineup this year, as we also have the Camon 17 P and the Camon 17 Pro. These devices were unveiled during an event held on the 6th of May as successors to the Technocamon 16 series of last year. The Technocamon 17 individually is an upgraded version of the Camon 16 with different features including the OS, camera layouts, design and storage, and a fast charging technology. So basically in this video, I'm going to be covering the specs, the features, the cons and pros of the 17 right here, and everything you should probably know before getting this guy. Here at the back of the Camon 17, we have a new camera layout featuring a 48 megapixel wide lens, a 2 megapixel f2.4 depth lens, and a third unspecified lens with quad LED flash. The last cutout, which looks so much like a fourth lens, is actually not the lens, it's just techno being techno. We also have a glossy finish here at the back with a nice stripe pattern which feels so premium, and the bottom is where we have the Technocamon 17 branding, kind of the same with the new Spark 7P. There's also the fingerprint sensor right here at the back for authentication as compared to the side mounted fingerprint sensor on the higher end Pro. As far as camera quality matters, the Technocamon 17 triple camera setup is capable of taking 1080p full HD videos at 30 frames per second, which is the same as the Camon 16 and other average phones. Moving on to the size of the device, we have the micro USB port present here at the bottom of the phone. Still here, the USB Type-C port isn't a thing on lower end techno devices, I guess. There's also the appearance of the 3.5mm headphone jack for wired headphones. The speaker grill or microphone is also present here at the bottom with an absence of stereo speakers compared to the Camon 17 Pro. Nevertheless, audio on this device can get as loud as you probably prefer it, only that your fingers may come in the way when watching a video or playing games in landscape mode. At the right side of the device, we have the power button as well as the volume rocker, and over to the other side, we just have the SIM card and micro SD card slot, which is capable of containing two nano SIM cards and a micro SD card for a storage extension. Up top, we don't have anything at all, and here at the front of this phone, you can notice the 60 megapixel left-sided dot-in display selfie camera, which is actually not a new thing to the world of smartphones. We have been having that for some time now. As far as the display and size, this phone features a 6.6 inch display with a 90% screen to body ratio and 720p by 1600 HD IPS LCD display with 267 ppi density and 90Hz refresh rate, of course. By the way, if you are enjoying this video so far, please hit the like button below so more audience can be reached here on the channel. Diving right into the software of the Technocamon 17, we have got the Android 11 on HiOS 7.6 running on MediaTek Helio G87 12nm chipset. The Camon 17 is available in two storage options, the 128GB on 4GB of RAM and the 128GB on 6GB of RAM. Multitasking on this guy gets even better and pleasing, though not perfect when you have to run really heavy gaming apps and equally have a lot of background apps too. Battery life is pretty much the same as of the Camon 16, as we have the 5000mAh big battery on both phones. It can easily last a day and even more on a single charge with normal usage. As said earlier, the Camon 17 supports fast charging of up to 18W, and this comes as a blessing as you have the 18W charger present in the box when you purchase the device new, as compared to Apple iPhones that also support fast charging but excludes the charger from the box. An edge right there for the techno device. And coming over to the last segment of this video, a part that you might have probably waited for all this while, the cameras and camera quality. The Camon 17 consists of a triple camera including a 48 megapixel wide lens, a 2 megapixel f2.4 depth lens plus a third unspecified lens. It sports a 60 megapixel sensor at the front for selfies. I have extensively tested both cameras to the max, and here are the things I came up with for the different categories. Take a look.
What's up guys, I'm Michael here, and here I'm testing the front selfie camera 16 megapixel of the Technocamon 17 here in my situation. Now let me know what you think about the camera as well as the sound of the Technocamon 17 in the comment box right there. You can see up in this area, you can see it's kind of exposed, overexposed, and when I move it up here, you can see the autofocus is kind of slow. You can notice the difference there. So let me just know what you think about the sound, about the quality of the video right here. You can see the back here is kind of low, but let me know what you think about the front camera, the selfie camera of the Technicam 17 right here in the comment box.
So it's safe to say that the cameras on this guy are somewhat cool and even good enough to stand out in this generation of kind of affordable phones, at least for the price. Though there are some exemptions to being the ideal camera, like the Samsungs, the Apples, or the Pixels, but hey, it's a nice option if you are considering to get an interesting phone for a daily driver. Thanks for watching, guys. Let me know what you think of the Technicam 17 right there in the comment box. Based on my experience, I'm drawing out the conclusion that we've got a nice design and build right there on the Technicam 17. Pretty cool cameras and processors too, and nice charging speed and technology. So what are your own thoughts based on what you have seen or heard about this guy? Is it really worth the price tag of 74,000 naira or $148? There are other options too, as I've said in this year's lineup, the Canon 17P for 125,000 naira or $250 and the Canon 17 Pro for 97,000 naira or $194. Do like this video if you found it entertaining and informative, and consider subscribing to the channel and make sure to turn on notifications to be notified when I eventually drop a new video. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.